Welcome everyone. So our today's topic is coordination in plants from class 9, and this topic is from lesson life processes in living organism. All right, so let's study what is coordination in plants. All right, so before looking the coordination of the plant, let's study first what is coordination. Okay, so we have seen that in our previous video also that several different organ system function in multicellular organism. Like different organ system are there, like in human body, digestive system is there, nervous system, circulatory, respiratory, skeletal system, muscular system, and many more systems. All right, so their life goes on smoothly if there is proper coordination between the different organ system or organs and the stimuli in the surroundings. Okay, and depending upon this, we can say that systematic regulation of different processes can be called as a control, and bringing about the different processes in the proper sequence, it is called as a coordination. That means control and coordination should be there in a body to perform the every system in systematic manner. So this is called as a coordination. That means when different organ system work in a proper sequence with proper control, it is called as a coordination. All right, so I hope you all have understood the meaning of coordination. Now let's move further. All right, so if any activity in the body is to be completed successfully, proper coordination between different organ system and organs participating at different step of that activity is necessary. If due to lack of coordination or some other factor there is confusion at any step, the activity may not get completed, and there should not be any randomness at any step. There need to be proper coordination, all right, between internal activity of the body resulting from various factors like body temperature, water level, enzyme level, etc., or stimuli arising in the surrounding environment. And proper coordination between various system of an organism helps to maintain a state of equilibrium, and this state of equilibrium is called as a homeostasis, which is necessary for the optimal efficiency of the body. All right, so this is all about the coordination. Now let's just understand the coordination in plants. Alright, now coordination in plants. So plants do not have systems like the nervous system or muscular system of animal. So in our body, like human body, there are different various organ systems are there to do the work in proper sequence. Okay, so but plant body do not have this system. So then how do the plants bring about movement? So in plants, movement are mainly in the form of responses given to the stimuli. Okay, so in plants, control and coordination is done by chemical substances, and these chemical substances are called plant hormones or phytohormones. Okay, so for the coordination, control, and for the growth of the plant, there are different hormones are present and called as a phytohormones or plant hormones. So these are the different hormones which are using for the which helps in coordination and control, like auxin, gibberellins, cytokinins, abscisic acid, and ethylene. Okay, so these all are the different hormones which with different functions. All right, okay, so tropic movement or tropism. So what is this tropic movement in plant? So movement or growth of any part of the plant in response to an external stimulus is called as tropism or tropic movement. Okay, or tropic movement or tropism is the movement of the plant in response to the stimulus present in the environment. This movement is in the response of root and shoot growth. Okay, so what is the stimulus? So this is something which causes the change or reaction in particular bodies, particular plants. Okay, so like if we provide the water or sunlight to the plant, so the growth of the plant will take place in that particular direction. So this is a stimulus, and plants will do according to the stimulus which have been provided by the environment. Okay, all right, so first The shoot system of any part, any plant responds to the light stimulus, that is, it grows towards the source of the light, and the movement shown by the plant towards the source of the light is called as a phototropic movement. Okay, so now here you can observe the alongside picture in which you can observe the sunlight is the plant is growing towards the sunlight. Okay, so this plant is bending of the plant toward the sunlight. Okay, the shoot of this, now what is the shoot system which present the above the soil, this is called as a shoot, and which is there below the soil, it is called as the root system. Okay, so due to the phototropic movement, the plants are bending towards the light and the growth of the shoot system of the plant is taken place. All right, so this is also called as a phototropism. Okay, now next type is the root system of plant respond to stimulus like gravitation and water. Okay, now this is the root system and this is called as a hydrotropic, that means for water, and gravitropic for the gravitational force. Okay, now gravitational force means earth has a gravitational force just to attract them every object towards itself. Okay, and these responses are also called as a hydrotropism and gravitropism. All right, so this is a alongside picture in which you can observe the plant is growing, the root of the plant is growing in the influence of gravitation and water. So this is a hydrotropism or gravitropism, roots of the plant. All right, this is a chemotropic movement in which the movement shown by plants in response to a specific chemical is called as a chemotropic movement. All right, and it is also called as a chemotropism. Now for example, the growth of the pollen tube towards the ovule, so this is an example of a chemotropic. Like you can observe here, this is a structure of a carpel in which the growth of the pollen grain takes place towards the ovule. So this is an example of a chemotropism. All right, now in previous slide we have seen like gravitropism, phototropism, hydrotropism. All right, so these all are the movement of a plants are related with the growth, that means due to these tropic movement the plant growth has been taken place, and that's why collectively it is called as a growth relevant movement. All right, so these all like phototropism, hydrotropism, chemotropism and gravitropism are called as a collectively called as a growth relevant movement. All right, now do you know students, so tendrils of climbers are sensitive to touch. All right, and a hormone called auxin produced in the apical part of the shoot helps in the enlargement of the cells. Now apical part means that means the top parts of the plant like bud or anything else. So hormones like gibberellins help in the stem elongation and cytokinins help in the cell division. So these are the different, like in our previous slide we have seen auxin, gibberellins and cytokinins are different hormones of the plant which help in the growth of the plant, like different part of the plant. All right, so the hormone abscisic acid is effective in prevention and retardation of a growth, leaf wilting, etc. Now we leaf wilting means the bending of the leaf in downward direction and becomes very weak, and this is due to the loss of less providing water or over watering to the plant and too much direct sunlight. So due to this the leaf becomes wilting and they die, that means they fall off. All right, so here the plant, touch me not plant or mimosa plant is there, in which you can observe when we touch the plant it becomes closes, the leaves of this plant becomes close. Okay, so in this plant the movement also occur at the places other than where it has been touched, and hence we can infer that the information about the touch must have been relayed within the plant from one place to another. That means we are here, you can see that the finger, the leaf has been touching at the end part of the stem. Okay, end part of the stem, and the all the leaf are closing. So this is the movement, that means information has been transformed from one part of the plant to the another part of the plant, and plant use electrochemical impulses for transfer of information from one place to another. Okay, and plant cell change their shape by increasing or decreasing their water content and thereby bring about the movements of the plant. All right, now this is the next example. So in the plant called Venus flytrap, there is a trap that appears and smells like flowers and deceives insects. That means this, due to the smell of the or fragrance of the flower, the insects are getting onto the plant. Okay, and when an insect visits that flower like trap, the trap closes up and the trap insect indigested by the plant. So you can clearly observe from the picture. Okay, now lotus flower opens during the day time while that of the tuberose or polyanthus opens at night time. All right, now fibrins present on the leaves of insectivorous plant Drosera bend inwards as soon as an insect lands on the leaves and surround the insect from all the side. You can observe that when the insect will sit on the plant, the leaves of the plant will surround the insect from all the sides. Okay, so in plant like balsam, the ripened fruit dehisces or burst open at the right time to disperse the seed. You can observe how the fruit is opening and dispersing the seeds just to give a growth to the plant. All right, now some specific movement of the plant do not lead to the plant's growth, and such movement are called as a growth irrelevant plant movement. Now before we have seen the growth relevant movement, that means the movement which are related to the great growth of a plant, they are growth relevant, and some movement of the plant which do not lead to the plant's growth, they are called as a growth irrelevant movement. All right, and as a response to changes in the surrounding, the plant hormones bring about various movement in the plants. So different plant hormones are there, so they bring about various movements in the plant. So student, that's it for today's video. I hope you all have understood this very simple concept of coordination in plant. And next part of the video we will continue in our next session. Thank you all of you with the great wishes of Diwali. Happy Diwali. Thank you.